Alright, finally. Goodness gracious. Oops. Good old Reborn mod Borderlands here. Borderlands 2, that is, at least. Just trying to get to level 72 right now so we can hit third playthrough at full level. Get some of the schleamy level guns. I don't know, maybe you are. Ooh, hello. Oh, I need to place the stupid... Oh, it's over there, okay. It's alright, I'll feed Dookie. Oh, should I now? Oh, looks like you got fucked up. Lupino! Gotcha, bud. Yeah, that's good. Let's find you a home, new little buddy. Respond. Hi, Jiggle Me GPU. Welcome. How was work today, Jiggle? Oh wow, that quest works all the way out here. Amazing. Can you hear me, Will? Or Jiggle, sorry. I am speaking. We need this house. Bada bing, bada boom. Our new house, bucko. I got $448. Well, finished my computer last night. That was fun. Fuck. We need this. The food killed you. What the? Oh heavens. Oh. Easy peasy.
This is the sheriff. Rumors that Lynchwood might become as civilized as opportunity are not to be believed.
Oh heavens! Can't have none of that. No, no. Opportunity isn't exactly the shining sea on the hill as it would be. This is amazing. Yeah, that CPU is worth picking up. Now I can just play. Not worry about nothing. Okay. Oh, fucking A. Yeah, okay. Yeah, cool, cool story, bro. Boom, trinkets being right there. Boop. Boop. A lot of money. Alright. Crack. Dead. Oop. None of that. Not having none of that. I say hi as well. What'd you guys end up doing for Mother's Day, by the way? I'm pretty sure you probably just like ended up cooking or something, doing whatnot. I know you ended up in my house though, so. Crack. Oh, that sounds like a fun Mother's Day. Alfred, yeah. That's hilarious. I made pasta as well. I just made basically the stuff we made at your house that one day, the chicken and pasta sauce with some spinach. Turned out delicious. I also got the speaker, like the hooked up the receiver for her, so yeah. It was pretty delicious.
Rick always did have a flair for the dramatic.
I love that I can play it like normal settings now. It's so great. The receiver, the Sony thing I got for. So it hooks up to the speakers in the living room and stuff. Oh, I left some people alive. Dead. And it's the best. What is the best? She's yeah, it works for her. You just need better. She needs better speakers for sure. Sniped him. But other than that, yeah, it's pretty solid. Dead. That's why we do that. Rip. Bat. Bat. $39.50, but yeah, it really is, though. It really is, though. But, bro, I was actually... I did some research on the $59.50. It's actually... It's going to be an insane upgrade, though. Like, in a few years, you know... Oh, then again, if the U.S. is still here and it doesn't completely implode. But the $39.50 built... I mean, the $59.50 is built, like, way different. So... It's going to be a nice upgrade. But... It's going to be a while. Obviously.
Pistols at high noon.
Alrighty. Yeah, like I was watching, I think it was Linus's video on or something. Like the gains over just $39.50, let alone like the Intel competitor at the time, is insane. But $39.50X is, yeah, it's fine. Well, not fine. I mean, it's like insane, but yeah. I need a pistol. I have a slag pistol. No, Deputy Winger. No, bud. No. No, I didn't shoot him. Damn it. Oh well. Yeah, 800. Yeah, they're 800, but I mean, for the McGains, if you're looking at McGains, I mean, that's 800 at Micro Center, which somehow has them. That's the thing. But I mean, in terms of McGains, it's not bad. It's not a bad CPU. I couldn't personally justify it. I mean, that's before warranty too. You know, like an extra, yeah. Oh, this is the zero, yeah. Good Krieg's shield right there.
Grab whatever files you can on Jack.
Oh, it's too late. I already killed him. I'll read it right now, so. Ooh, any more fire or that's a good question. Just barely, but we'll give it a shot. Almost done with that.
Hey, you found all the gun parts. Bring them back here and I'll assemble them for you.
Bet. Yeah, this thing is super effective.
their loot.
Hey, Roland. I appreciate your offer to move into Sanctuary, but I got a lot of stuff here at Firestone. The Sanctuary sounds nice and all, but Firestone's my home. I made my decision. If I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die in the city I was born. Firestone.
Oh, come on, Zed. Be a little principled, would you? Damn. Oh no, it's Bonehead. Dead.
Organizing the construction out in the Nexus. No matter what happens, make sure that old bandit town that Firestone, I think it's called, make sure it stays standard. And the several rest stops where it all began. Oh, and another thing. I want it on company policy that instead of Firestone, we're changing its name to Jackville. Really twist the knife for those bandit bastards. You know what I mean? I want those bulk hunting sons of bitches to see what I've done to this place. I want it to be a testament to their faith.
Oh really? Like that's gonna work for you? Oh yeah, that's right. You can do that. Ooh. Fucking rip. Jeez.
Looking for the vault.
first gun my uncle ever gave me.
Oh, can you now? Do explain, please. That ain't a gun. No.
I'm sorry, I can't offer you more.
I've been bamboozled.
Of iridium I've got into you, but this stupid key isn't working. Why? I'm sorry, I don't know.
You're a siren. You're one of a kind. Now make it work. I want that freaking warrior, Angel. I want him, okay? I want him under my control now. I want him now. Not later, now!
Wild!
wife suggested as much before her disappearance.
Jimmy, please make a note on strangling Mr. Moore for bringing up my wife. Mr. Moore. No, no, Jimmy. Choking is something you do when you eat too fast. As I'm brushing Mr. Moore's windpipe with my watch chain, what I'm doing is actually referred to as strangling. There we go. Anything else on today's agenda?
No!
Jimmy. It's Jeffrey, sir. And no. Thanks, Jimmy. Well then. Drinks are on Handsome Jack.
Oh goody. Wonder if Saturn respawns. We'll go figure that out real quick. I hear you. Anyway. Be a yes. Thank you. think everything.
Join Max Stick soon. The enkindling approaches. It is time for the enkindling. Time to sacrifice heathens to our blazing mother.
Wait, you said the enkindling? That could be very bad. Or it could be like a cookout or something. Just keep an open mind about it, you know? These guys aren't so bad.
You have done so well, Torch. Once the enkindling is complete, we shall all receive our reward in the fight. The preparations are complete! Return to me, and let the human sacrifice commence!
Okay, that sounds pretty evil. Just head to this encampment.
A bit.
Creepy, I'll make an appearance. Be careful.
Thank you. I'll let the Goliath fight this one out. Oh, fuck you. No, I think so. Somebody wanted, I think it was on Parler, they wanted me to talk about Stadia and how bad it's been. Like, listen, like, Stadia is horrible, obviously. I mean, one, it's made by one of the worst corporations on the planet. Other than that, though, I mean, like, the reason it exists, though, is because, I mean, like, look at what the gaming community or whatever buys already. Every year, like, what, Call of Duty's always the top, Battlefield sells like crazy, even though it's fucking garbage. All these garbage games, all this bullshit, like, Assassin's Creed, like, look at where Assassin's Creed is now. It used to be amazing. Now what is it? Basically just a microtransaction platform with some, like, Viking game built on. I almost bought it, but I was like, alright, let me wait 6 months. Oh, because, of course, Ubisoft is, you know, they're the wait-for-the-sale company because, you know, 2 months after the game launches, it's always on sale for a ridiculous amount. But still hasn't been a good place. Anyway, but, like, what do they do? They just push microtransactions, and then, you know, so then you're going to start getting these games / companies where they're just like, oh, well, you know, these moronic gamers are just going to buy anything, so fuck it. Might as well. So, what do you get? You get a platform that basically Call of Duty, just an entire game streaming platform. They're literally for nothing but just to suck the money out of the gamers. Like, and, you know, the only people to blame are, you know, us gamers as well. Like, you know, like, gosh. I've been around for a while, but, you know, like, I used to play, like, I played Call of Duty back in Big Red 1. Like, back in the old days. Gosh. So, you know, the only way we can make this kind of stuff change is if, you know, we just stop buying the crap. You want Call of Duty to change? Stop buying Call of Duty. You want Assassin's Creed to change? Stop buying Assassin's Creed. It's just that simple. You know, screw the, you know, all the rant videos, all leaving the nasty comments, oh, the review bombs, and, like, whatever, you know, however rightly deserved they are. Like, it's not going to change anything. Just stop buying it. It's that simple. What's the point of buying it and then leaving a nasty review? They have your money. You know, like, they ain't gonna give, I mean, for the most part, once you spend the, you know, they're not gonna give you your money back for the most part, so, you know, how about we just stop buying all this crap? Like, there's already insane games, like especially on Steam, like, all the games on sale and everything. The only reason Stadia exists is because people, corporations and people looking to make a quick buck realize that gamers will buy anything if it's shiny enough. So, you know, fuck it. Stop buying the shiny shit. Stop buying these games and just fucking play Borderlands. Like, you can pick up Borderlands 2 for cheap probably now. And then, you know, look at all the content they give you for that. What, you're gonna pay $60 every year for Call of Duty that's just Control C, Control V on the code? Maybe they change the look of it. Woohoo! Why? What's the point? Yeah, like, I used to buy Call of Duty every year, because it's Call of Duty, you know, there's no other game quite like it. I understand that. However, after a while, this shit's garbage. Okay, like, damn. So, you know, stop buying the shit, and then we'll get better stuff, but until that happens. The only reason Call of Duty's microtransaction heavy is because people buy in the shit. If people stop buying it, we'll be fine. But no. All these morons that keep buying it and they're like, ooh, it doesn't stop. It's like, you are the problem. Like, when Call of Duty has a freaking, a battle pass that you have to pay $10 for to unlock 75% of the content is, in a $60 game, is insane. Now, if it was different battle passes for the people that paid and the people that just download Warzone, okay, then, because Warzone's free, whatever. But it's not. So, whatever. But people buy it up. People buy, you know, Cold War, I believe, is like one of the better selling ones now. So, congratulations. That game is freaking garbage. I didn't buy it. That's just dumb. I'm not gonna waste $60. It's even gone on sale like 3 times. I ain't buying it. I played it for free. It's garbage. It's like on the free weekends. Like it's just garbage. Modern Warfare is phenomenal. That, you know, Modern Warfare was phenomenal, 2019. So, and that's got oodles of content, which is surprising because they actually gave us some content. Not a lot. I mean, not the most. All the skins and all the battle passes, all that shit should just be earnables, you know, like, I don't know, like 5 years ago or something like that? 6 years? 7 years ago? Maybe I'm a boomer, you know, but like, damn, bro. Like, yeah, this is kind of deviating from Stadia, but like, Stadia's garbage. It had a good idea. Like, don't get me wrong, game stream, that's cool, because like, you know, I've tried out the Nvidia one, GeForce Now, because that's cool. It's cool, you know. Especially, I mean, but it's such a, unless I'm wrong, but it's just like, it seems very niche. Like, high speed internet, yet you don't have the hardware to run it. Okay. That makes sense, I guess, but or you're whatever you want to call it. You're on the road or whatever, and you're just kind of chilling. You know, I get that. So, I mean, it's cool. I prefer hardware, but it's whatever. I prefer to, well, own my games, quote unquote. Be nice. I start buying DVDs again. So. But I don't know. Stadia failed because for a lot of reasons. One, the pricing model is idiotic. Yeah, pay us a subscription fee, then pay us for the games. And by the way, they're all old ass games that no one really plays, and they run like garbage. And you have to pay full $60 price. Like, who in their right mind is gonna pay $60 for Assassin's Creed Odyssey base? If you do, you're an idiot. I'm sorry, but you are. That game, I bought the Schleim Whale Edition for like $20 because it went on sale like 6 months to a year after. But no, pay $60 on top of a, what, $5 or $10 subscription fee every month on top, you know, with garbage latency and all this other crap. But okay, if that's what you want to do, go for it. Far be it for me to tell you how to spend your money. I just think it's stupid. Don't get me wrong. I spend my money on dumb stuff all the time. For sure. However, I try to give as little money as possible to Google. Especially all these other AAA people. Yeah, I got burned on Borderlands 3. I mean, that was, oof. All aboard the hype train. I mean, gameplay is amazing. Story is so awful. But whatever, you know. But yeah, anyway, I mean, I don't know. Yeah, Stadia, waste of money, scam, whatever. I mean, I saw it going from the beginning. I was like, oh, Google's gonna make a, yeah, okay. Yeah, what's it gonna cost? Like, oh, yeah, it's $10? Okay. Yeah, oh, is it, yeah. And you gotta pay for the games? Dumb. DOA. They're trying to have their cake and eat it too, and charge you a subscription to eat the cake. Like, fuck out of here. Google can keep my money. The most, and I'm sorry, they just came out with a search bar feature. Google, like, come on. I know it's been covered already, but really? Telling me the whole company built on search? I mean, it was really built by the government too, but telling me they just implemented search feature on their, yeah, okay. Okay. Why should I invest my dollar dues into that? That's just stupid. Not that dollar dues are worth much. Gosh. Well, your dollars are worth something. Worth however much Bitcoin you can get for. Not giving a financial advice. I'm just saying. Bitcoin's awesome. No, I think it's actually tanking right now, which is great. Watch me in the gutter. I don't know. It's back up again. 50. But yeah, that ends my rant on Stadia, whatever, and current state of the gaming market, I guess you could suppose. Moral of the story is stop buying the garbage shit and we'll start getting some good shit. But no, it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen because people are like, oh, I want to spend $24 on a skin that after a year, well, I mean, after a year or so, you know what? No, this all comes from the morons who keep buying the FIFAs, the Maddens, the NBAs, like freaking decimal point beginning IQ people. Stop buying that crap, for fuck's sakes. Gosh, it's just idiotic. Like, stop buying it. It's so awful. And that's half the reason we have, like, that's why you get Stadia. That's why you get Call of Duty. That's why you get the Assassin's Creed and the Division. I mean, Division 2 is okay. But, like, this is the whole reason. It's because morons just keep buying this garbage for forever. And then just like, oh, why do we keep getting garbage? Well, if you stop buying the garbage, maybe. Can only help. Or, best case scenario, EA goes broke. Ubisoft goes broke, Activision goes broke, and then we get new companies that actually give a shit and actually will make good content, good quality games. But not if you keep buying it. Just stop buying it. It's that simple. It's not. You don't need regulation. You don't need all this government hoo-ha. You don't need all these commissions. Just stop buying the games. It's that easy. But no. We need the government to come in and fix our own problems because we can't possibly fix them ourselves, even though it would be simple as put the credit card, put the debit card away, stop buying the shit, play the probably dozens of games you already have, whatever. I mean, that's what I'm doing. I'm done buying games for a long time because I got this huge library and all I do is keep buying games. It's stupid. I'm just going to play the games I already own. I'm gonna play them all the way through, and I'm 100% them all, and whatnot, whatever, and I'll have a good day. I just don't get it anymore. At this point, no. Use that $60. Say if you buy one game a year, put that $60 into something like a hard asset. I mean, I'm not giving financial advice, but damn, just put it into like something that will actually go up in value. Unless it's like, you know, I don't know. I'm not giving financial advice, but it's just like. That's what I would do, me personally. Is that financial? I don't know. I just don't get it anymore. I'd rather put my $60 to something more important than a video game. That's just me. You guys do what you want. I'm not giving advice.
Listening to those Hyperion newscasts to see you killing kids and kicking puppies. I found the guy who's recording. He's in the arid nexus. Pay him a visit.
Well, yeah, and that's it. Just stop buying garbage. We'll start getting some good games. Hopefully. I don't know. Cyberpunk was a big slap in the face if I've ever seen one. I was hyped. I was like, nah, it's gonna be great. They're just so good. And yeah. Pre-order. That's another thing. Stop fucking pre-ordering shit. It's gonna be the same game 6 months from now than it... Well, I mean, with the current state of games, you know... It's gonna be the same game. Probably better, because there won't be so many freaking bugs and there'll be actual content. 6 months later, 5 months, whatever, a few months later, for probably the same price or even a discounted price. So what's the point of pre-ordering? What's the point of getting on a release date? Oh, I guess if you're streaming, I guess, and you gotta have it first. You gotta do it. Nah, it's just stupid. I mean, if money's no object, fine. But golly. The only reason we get the garbage is because we are more than happy to pay for it, so. Until that changes, nothing else is really gonna change. And no amount of government regulation can fix that, by the way. That's all to do with the market and the consumer. They are merely providing a product that people are searching for, which is a garbage games with little to no content, full of bugs. And why get mad at the companies when it's all of us buying it? Can't really get mad at the company.
Herein is Scooter's poem for you, Daisy.
It's like getting mad at Ford for making a truck. Daisy. People are buying trucks, people are buying garbage games, so they're gonna get garbage games.
You want my camera, huh? Thanks, sugar. I've been
great. Take that camera to Albert's. And make sure you don't get prices
footage. Jacob's Vladoff. Alright, that ends my rant. I'll try to clip that and upload as a separate video. On YouTube, of course. I don't think I can do that on here. You know what? I don't need. I know this. The amount of times I've played this game in an hour, I could probably recite the entire thing. So I don't really need subtitles. it's worse in literally every single way. I don't know about that one.
Let me know if anything catches your eye.
Nope.
Remember, we're always
looking. Demon Hunter, yeah. Naturally, I don't care. Yep, don't care about that. What is this? Chill. Yeah, okay, whatever. Oh, yeah, Terramorphous. Oh, yeah, we can go do that. Let's do everybody else first. And then let's do this. Ooh, that looks cool. Oh, yes, please. Let's go slower. Where you running, you little bitch? Yep.
Chaos across Pandora. These pathetic bandits claim to have opened the vault. Should you encounter the...
It's a fine day, full of opportunity.
Pickle Rick! Logistically. Oh, what the hell? An E-Tech Torg. Okay. Now I am interested. Huh. I'll give it a shot. Why not? What do I have to lose? Let's actually put that there. Let's put this here. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. mommies and daddies gave up so your family could live an opportunity? Literally nothing! Your family is paid to be here. I'm the one who feeds and protects everyone. Remember, we should all love our parents.
I didn't sign up for this, damn it. God damn murdering bastard! You fellas meet the missus?
Get fucked, Constructor.
Thank you.
broadcast that footage you shot.
Workers of opportunity, you fine gentlemen are building the future. Once the city is done and its carefully selected citizens are brought in, you'll be able to see the true beauty that opportunity represents. From a distance, that is. If you guys aren't coming anywhere near the city once it's done, you can check it out. Binoculars.
What a jackass.
Quick. Yo, 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 yo! Let's blow stuff up! Lil told me there's a train full of money comes around here. Sounds like a job.
Those miners you fought earlier were paid cash.
Alright, well, thank you for everybody that tuned in. This has been another episode. this is technically Ultimate Journey 100%, Ultimate 100% Journey part, like, 23, 24, something stupid like that. So I'm just gonna stop counting, because it's just stupid. Thank you for tuning in. Be back tomorrow, most likely, hopefully. Not sure what we're playing, but we'll be playing something. 8 p.m. Remember to like and hit the subscribe button. All right, well, have a nice night, everybody. And, yeah.